Welcome back to Hot Copy. You're watching YouTube sensation David DiMuzio.
Yes.
All right, I said it right. And all right, questions from Twitter and Facebook for you. CJ asks, describe Filipino songs in no more than three Tagalog words. So meaning pick three Tagalog words to describe Filipino songs.
Galing.
Galing.
Maganda.
Maganda. You're good, huh?
Kulit.
What?
Kulit.
Kulit. Kulit. Okay. Coratina asks, are you married? If not, can we meet? Can I bring you home?
Okay.
Yeah, just the kind
send
of person you want. Send him a picture. That was her?
No.
Okay. All right. Carlo Laliste says he should cover Glock 9 songs. What is Glock 9?
Glock 9 is a rapper, yeah.
Do you rap?
Not at all.
Not
no.
at all.
That's not
okay. going to
happen.
All right. Eduardo Alcantara asks, do you consider yourself a novelty act?
No, definitely not.
Yeah, no. Yeah, I agree. Mm. All right, because one, you're a songwriter, so the talent will stay forever.
That's kind of how I feel. I mean, if I was only covering songs in Tagalog, then I feel like it would be kind of a novelty thing. But I do Tagalog covers more for my own pleasure.
Yes.
Just because I, you know, it's fun for me to learn new songs. It's like new chords, like new melodies. But really, my skill is as a songwriter.
All right. Now, can you sing us one original song that's very special to you?
Gosh, all my original songs are special to me.
Okay, go ahead. Anything. The story behind it.
Won't be something. Actually, I need my capo. Can you?
I want to make
capo
you mine.
Out of there?
No.
Let's do this song. This is a song, another Taglish song. This is probably going to end up being my second single, actually.
All right,
and,
Taglish.
I wrote it with Topsu Zara, and so that's kind of an honor for me because I'm a big fan of Topsu Zara. Actually, you know this song. Sabihin mo na kung anong gusto mo.
Yes, I know that song.
Yeah, great song, right? Top wrote that song, and then I thought, wouldn't it be cool to write that in English, like an English version?
Okay.
Yeah, that's it. And so, So I wrote this. Is actually an English translation of Sabihin Mo Na. So the verses are an exact English translation,
okay.
And then the chorus I changed up.
All right.
Yeah, it's like this. We'll grab this. I can play this later. Cool.
Myself to you, but you're not talking to me. No, so now I'm asking you to hear me out, share your common ground. All of us make mistakes, and it didn't mean it. Let me, I'm making it up. You'll see it. Yeah. Tell me now, I'll do anything. Palasayo, kahit ano'y gagawin at kagayanin ko, haharapin ang mga amo mo. Tell me now, I'll do anything para sa'yo. Para sa'yo. You've been ignoring me for days, but I can't sit and wait. No, so now I'm asking you to hear me out. Share your common ground. All of us make mistakes, and it didn't mean it. Let me, I'm making it up. You'll see, yeah. Tell me now, I'll do anything. Para sa'yo, kahit ano'y gagawin at kagayanin ko, haharapin ang mga amo mo. Tell me now, I'll do anything. Para sa'yo. Para sa'yo. Tell me now, I'll do anything. Tell me now, I'll do anything. Tell me now, tell me now. Whoa. Anything para sa'yo. Para sa'yo. Sabihin mo na.
Para sa'yo. Go! gosh. Thank you. There's so much feeling and passion when you sing.
Thanks.
Yeah. So do you know a lot of the Filipino composers already by now?
Yeah, I've met
You've
a bunch.
You've been working with them.
Yeah, like Vinny Satorno, he invited me to his studio.
Are you serious?
Yeah, Vinny is awesome. He's a great songwriter.
Did you do anything with him?
I haven't written with him yet. I'd really like to. We talked about it, so hopefully at some point we'll get a chance to write
together. Okay, you wrote for Geneva Cruz, you said.
Yes, actually her new single, it should be out pretty soon, I think. It's on Poly East, and she's come out with a new album. She's on, I think, Pinoy Big Brother coming up, and so she's releasing it partly in promotion with that.
None of us knew that she's going to be in Pinoy Big Brother, but never mind. Oh, okay. You surprised us. But go ahead.
I think she is. That or Survivor, one of those shows. Okay. And it's called To Manila, actually. And it's a song about the Philippines. And
Can you sing it?
Okay, yeah,
okay,
sure.
Okay, because you wrote this. So this is a song David wrote for Geneva Cruz.
Yes, yes, yes.
And the title is To Manila.
That's correct. Yeah, yeah. Let me see. Go. I've never really played this myself because I wrote
it for
her.
Just a few lines.
Too many. Okay, yeah, let me do it right here. Sorry.
Yes. Take your time.
It's like...
If you think it's always raining in Seattle.
Are you nice?
You've never been to where I'm from. Cause a downpour is not a downpour till the swimming pools become swimming. The streets all become swimming pools. The kids all having fun. I can catch a jeepney from QC to Timbuktu. The less you can hate a cab and ride a block or two. I miss the traffic, the smog, to hold in too many malls blocking my view. You're always who I'm coming home to. Fiestas is strong. Everything's gonna be okay. Cause when the karaoke starts to play, it calls me home to Manila. To Manila.
You know what's ironic?
That's the first time I've ever played that.
No, you know what's extremely ironic for me? Because, of course, there's a song about New York. I mean, you know, the famous song now, Empire.
Empire
New York
State of Mind.
So it's about loving New York. And now there's a song about loving Manila, and a foreigner wrote it. Now, that's really funny.
You know, one of the things is, like, and a couple of people have said this to me, because I'm a foreigner, I think I notice things sometimes about the Philippines that I love that Filipinos might actually take for granted because
Absolutely.
You see it every day.
Yeah,
you know?
Like name me one thing you love about Manila.
You know, actually, like even something like jeepneys. Like the first time I rode in jeepney, I'm like, this is so cool. Like in the U.S., this would totally be illegal, you know? But here, it's like you can just like jump on the back. There's like kids. No, you know what? Actually, my favorite thing is this. Like for me, like in it's like. It's so beautiful. Mm-mm. It's like when it's raining and you're driving and you go to one of the slum areas. And in a way, I find this really beautiful. And there's all
because
the kids.
Because you're a romantic at heart.
The kids, they're like taking showers. Like the water is coming off of the top of like the, you know, their sheds or whatever. All and right. then and they're taking showers and bathing and they're all laughing. And like the kids in the street are all like.
Of course, no one does that in the U.S.
Of course not. And you know, and I'm like, man, this is so like adorable to see these kids. Like they don't have anything, you know, but when it rains, like. Suddenly they're so happy and they're like the streets are swimming pools for them, you know.
Yeah,
it's like
that's
their
a nice
playground
way to put it, huh?
Yeah, for me it's like wow, it's so
All
beautiful,
right.
you know.
Wait, another original song.
I'll play you part of the song that I wrote for Noy Volante.
Okay.
So it's an English song. Yeah,
okay.
yeah.
For Noy Volante.
This is kind of my first like break in the Philippines, and so
okay,
I really appreciate him.
Is it famous? This. Did this become famous?
You know, actually, it was supposed to be this is second single, but it ended up not.
Okay.
So I'm hoping that Noy and I played it live a few times. I'm hoping that he releases it at some point. Or if not, maybe another artist will.
After a week or two of hanging around with you, I didn't think we'd ever work out. You were ready to fall in love, and I was rolling along. Now look, you settled down. You impressed me with the way everybody loved you made me second guess. And I'm glad I guessed again. If I'm supposed to let you go, why does it hurt me?
Shouldn't that have been a single?
Yeah, I think so. Now wait, another song from this single.
No, it was actually, it was released on MCA. It just wasn't released as a single. So okay. It's on his album on MCA.
All right, so how many songs will you have on your album?
There's
Let's talk about your album.
15 songs.
15, okay. So David is coming out with this album. All of us, we should support David. He's
Thank
an independent you. Artist. It's very rare that you get someone as passionate about the Philippines and as talented as him. Now, so the name of the album is David DiMuzio.
It's a self-title, yes.
It's a self-title. The thing is, when you see this on the store, you'll think that it's a foreign artist.
Yes.
I know.
Well,
you
hopefully,
know what I mean?
I hopefully
Unless
people have seen me.
Unless you were standing in front of a jeepney or something, right?
Yes.
Okay. No, so anything else from this album, since there are 15 songs?
Yes,
Go
yes.
ahead.
Okay, let's do this song.
What a Taste of Life.
I want to do Feet on the Ground.
Okay, what?
We haven't rehearsed that song.
All right, okay.
But Carla really likes it.
I want to do that.
Oh my gosh.
What It Takes to Fly.
This guy, seriously, I'm not bringing you next time.
Okay, go. Is that a good one? Maganda ba yun? O sobrang ganda daw.
Okay, all right, I'll do my best. This is like the hardest song on my album to sing. That's why I don't
want
to do it.
We're an easy audience.
Life a traffic jam, feels like there always is. I'm just trying to get home to a girl that I swear exists. I got my arm out the window, I've got my head leaning back, and staring at the sky, almost hoping that I cry. Somebody to love, somebody to love. Before the day rises, before the night falls, I'm gonna make you mine. If your breath is the sky and the stars are your eyes, I'll climb to you, I'll find what it takes to fly.
Very good. So that song, how long did it take you?
Actually, that song, it's a funny story. I've been writing some songs with Mike Chan. One of the Sabado Boys.
Sabado Boys.
Yes, they're
okay.
Formerly the Sabado Boys. And so Mike and I got together. And this particular time, some songs we've written together, and we've both written. But
yes.
This song, we got in a room. And I wrote all of it.
Can I tell you, you look like the lead singer in Maroon 5.
Oh, wow.
You know, right. What's the name of that
Adam
guy?
Levine?
You
Adam
super
Levine?
Look like
wow,
him.
Oh, thank you. He's yeah, kind of attractive.
No, all right. Well, you have so many fans, huh? Mac Bermuda. Hi, David. I'm so crushing on you right now.
Yeah.
I hope to see you on a regular performer on ASAP. Yeah. Wow. Oh, Surfer Joe 2020, I sent you a friend request on Facebook. But you have too many friends. Okay. All right.
The best place to add me on Facebook, because I have actually two personal accounts, but they're both about full, I think. And
my
so,
God. It must be hard to be you.
So actually, my fan page is facebook.com/DavidDiMuzio. I actually reply to all comments myself. So it's actually better to add me on my fan page than on my personal page, because my personal page, I really don't check that much. I just kind of log on to get on my fan page. So if you add my fan page and you comment on my wall, I will respond. respond. So okay. Every single comment I respond to.
All yeah. right. Yeah. Well, we don't have enough time. We end at 9 o'clock, but of course okay. we can listen to you all day. But I want to tell the public, please buy David's album, David DeMuzio. It's coming out in...
First week of September.
First week of September. He's an independent artist, a foreigner at that, who sings Tagalog songs.
Yes, please vote for the video on Mix. You can text Mix Space Request Space, Naiisip Mo Ba, Mix Space Request Space.
But yeah. have you performed in Mix?
Not yet, hindi pa.
My God. You yeah. should perform there.
But it's number 12. My video is number 12 already? On the Pinoy Mix Countdown right
but
now.
But even the Music Up Late, we have that.
Music Up Late, I've performed on there. So thank you to Jai Ho for having me on Music Up Late.
Yes.
And can I just thank a couple people?
Please,
real fast.
Go ahead.
Lana Johnson, my publicist, Ralph Bricks, who's my driver slash really great friend here. Jobert Sucaldito for giving my number to
no,
you guys.
Yes, he's very supportive of you, Jobert.
I really appreciate Jobert. Yeah. He's been really nice. So yes. Also Jai Ho. Thanks everybody. And thank you very much, Karen, for having me on your show.
Absolutely, my
pleasure. It's like an honor for us. It's a blast.
Thank you so much. But I really hope to see you one day in ASAP singing.
I mean, that would be fantastic. Thank you.
Because you deserve it. Really, you deserve it to have a major singing career. Okay, that's